Students, welcome back. So coming to the next topic, that is the ARM register organization. So in the previous video, I explained about the ARM architecture, advanced RISC machine architecture. Now let's see this register organization or register sets. So as I said, ARM is nothing but it is a load or store architecture, because everything, whatever the operations that has to be performed in the ALU, that can be taken with the help of registers only. Okay, so the register organization is very important concept in the ARM process. Okay, now let's see. In ARM, everything will be handled by registers, that is storing and retrieving the data by ALU only through registers. So every microcontroller, so whatever the microcontroller you are taking, that every microcontroller must be having a lot of registers. So whatever the controller you are taking, so each controller is having their own registers. So those registers are used to store information. So registers are used to store information. So the count of the registers may vary from architecture to architecture. So ARM is having only 32-bit registers. Okay, it is a 32-bit size. And here they are having the registers. So these registers are used to store the information. They are the temporary registers, and the count of the registers may be vary from different controllers, from architecture to architecture. So in ARM, in advanced RISC machine, there are 13 general purpose registers. 13 general purpose registers, okay, available. So that is from R0 to R12. So 13 general purpose registers available, which are available for programmers to use. So from R0 to R12, the programmers can use any one of the registers from R0 to R12. Okay, and some special purpose registers will be there. So total there are 3 special purpose registers. 3 special purpose registers. So those are R13, R14, R15. So which are used to perform some specific task. Okay, so total it is 16 registers are there. So these 16 registers are divided into general purpose and the special purpose. 16 registers are divided into general purpose and special purpose. Okay, so in this 13 or the general purpose, which are you anyone can be used, means the programmers can use it to write the programs. They can use from R0 to R12. But the special purpose registers, or 3 special purpose registers, that is R3, R14, R15, will handle those 3 registers. Those can perform only some specific task. Okay, they are not used by the programmers. So what are this? What is R13 consists of R14 and R15? Everything will be seen in the structure. Now let's see this register structure. I said ARM register organization, it is a 16-bit register. Okay, so let's take R0, R1, R2, R3. R4, R5, R6, R7, R8, R9, R10, R11, okay, R12. These are the general purpose, and the remaining are the special purpose, like R13, R14, R15. And one more special register is there, that is a CPSR. I will explain this. So here, from R0 to R12, these are the general purpose register, means the programmers can use this register. And coming to R13, R14, R15, I said these are the special purpose registers. Okay, R13 is nothing but it holds a stack pointer. R14 is acts as a link register. And R15 is for program counter. So those registers are assigned to hold those information only. Means the R13 is only for stack pointer. Means the top of the stack will be stored here. Okay. So from R0 to R12, this is used for used by any programmers. And these are the special function registers. Let me write, this is a special function registers. Okay. So R13 is a stack pointer which holds the address of the top of the stack. These are all the temporary registers only, but it holds the address of the top of the stack. Now coming to the link register. What is a link register? So let's take, suppose a program is there. This is a main program. Okay. So here the subroutine is there. Okay. Just call R1 subroutine. So R1 is somewhere here. This is a subroutine. So the what about this link register? I am explaining about this link register. What information is stored in link register? Whereas in stack pointer, top of the stack, address of the top of the stack will be stored. In link register, what type of data will be stored? When the subroutine is called, the return address is stored in the link register. Suppose whenever call R1 means, so before going to R1, it stores the address. Again, whenever it coming back to the main program address, let's take this is 2000, okay, 2001 like this. So the 2001 address will be stored in link register. Call R1 means the controller jumps to R1 subroutine. After the execution of the program, it checks the link register. So where I have to come back. So by seeing the address in the link register, the controller returns to the main program and continue the program. So the link register is nothing but it holds the address of the written address of the subroutine. So after completion of the subroutine, again it comes back to the main program to complete the remaining steps in the program, to execute the remaining steps in the program. So that written address will be stored in the link register. Now coming to the program counter. So program counter, we already know that it stores the address of the next instruction to be executed. And coming to CPSR, CPSR means C for current, P for program, S for status, R for register. CPSR means current, program, status, register. Okay, so this is a general register organization. So it's consisting of 16-bit registers. Okay, from R0 to R12, it holds the acts as a general purpose registers used by any of the programmers. And these are the special purpose register used only to perform specific function like stack pointer, link register and the program counter. And one more register is a 16-bit register. That is a 32-bit register. CPSR is a 32-bit register, which is current program status register. So in the next video, I'll explain what this CPSR. Thank you.